It's been a tragic Easter Sunday for dozens of folks in New Orleans. Four fires in 12 hours have left dozens of people without a place to live, including young children. WDSU News reporter Rosa Flores is on your side with that story.
Well, according to the fire department, two of the four fires happened here in the 400 block of Flood Street. And take a look, this house is completely charred. The good news is, in this case, no one was displaced.
That wasn't the case in the 1200 block of Napoleon Avenue. NOFD says the fire started just before 6 a.m. on Sunday.
When you look at the damage, these families are going to have to start over.
The Red Cross says the fire left 10 adults and four children without a place to stay.
It's a heartbreaking case for children. The Red Cross makes sure that when we come out to a fire, we have a little stuffed toy that we give kids to kind of, you know, it's a small thing, but it's something that can help them feel better.
The Red Cross also responded to the 2500 block of North Claiborne. That fire left 23 people displaced, including Natasha Smith and her children.
We're going to have to move. We're going to have to find money to relocate, deposit, or stay in the homeless shelter or something like that.
In the 400 block of Flood Street, one house caught fire twice. The home was unoccupied, and one neighbor witnessed it all.
So then I run up the porch, open up the door. Of course, I gave it. That's when it just went whoosh, really bad, dark, black, acidy smoke coming out.
That's how four fires in 12 hours.
It's more horrible, which you're not having a house or anything, and you don't know if your landlord's going to do anything or what he's going to do. You're just hoping for the best, yep, and just praying.
And the NOFD tells us that the cause of all of these fires is still under investigation. On your side, I'm Rosa Flores for WDSU News.
The American Red Cross helped all the displaced families with a hotel stay for a few days and gift cards to purchase basic needs. Coming up tonight at 10, hear what one neighbor says he saw and heard before one of the homes went up in flames.